Hi everyone, welcome to my channel again. In this video, I'll be doing one question. The question involves this figure here, okay? This question tells you two things about this figure. First of all, it tells you the ratio of BM to MC is 1 to 2. So if I let the length of BM to be X, like this, the length of MC will be 2 times that, so it'll be 2X, okay? The second thing this question tells you about is the area of the triangle BGM is 1 cm squared. Triangle BGM is here, triangle BGM. And the area of that is 1 cm squared. So I'll just put a 1 here. This question asks you to find the area of the parallelogram ABCD. Okay? ABCD. This statement here, it tells you ABCD is actually a parallelogram. So it tells you something about it. One of the properties of parallelogram is that the side AD and its opposite side BC, the length are the same. So if we call the length of BC to be X plus 2X, then the length of AD will be 3X because they have to be the same. AD and BC have to be the same. So I'll write 3X here. 3X. Okay? So how to tackle this kind of problem? How do I find the area of the parallelogram? There are two very important things you have to know. 1 and 2, which I've written on the whiteboard. The first thing you need to know is you have to know how to prove two triangles are similar. Because once you prove two triangles are similar, you actually know a lot about them, such as their sides are proportional and the ratio of the area is the square of their length. Okay, I'll get into this very soon. The second important thing you have to know is if you look at this figure here, this big triangle, okay? If I slice this big triangle up into two smaller triangles, which I have one of them shaded in black and the other one shaded in red. And if I also tell you the base of this black triangle is X and the base of this red triangle is Y, so the ratio is X to Y, then I can tell immediately that the area of this black shaded triangle to the area of this red shaded triangle is also X to Y. If you ask me how I know that, I can quickly show you. Let me draw this out to you. So if I draw out the black shaded triangle here first, so like this. Okay, so this is the black shaded triangle. And if I call the base of this triangle to be X, okay, the length of the base is X. And the height of this triangle is H, which is the same as what I shown here. Okay, what is the area of this triangle? It should be pretty simple, right? It should be X times H divided by 2, right? So if I draw this red shaded triangle out here, like this, and the base of this triangle is Y, and the height of this triangle is H, which is the same as the height of this black shaded triangle here. So if we look at this triangle again, what is the area of this triangle? It should be pretty simple, right? It's Y times H divided by 2. So if you look at this value here and this value here, it shouldn't be too hard to know to figure out that the ratio of this and this is X to Y. Because both have H over 2, if we cancel them out, H over 2 cancel them out, we can immediately see that the ratio is X to Y. Okay, so what's our conclusion of this second point here? The conclusion is if the ratio of the base of this black shaded triangle to the base of this red shaded triangle is X to Y, then the area is also X to Y. Is also X to Y. Okay? So after we understand these two very important points, now we can go ahead and try to answer this question. What is the first important point that I talk about? The first thing I talked about is try to find out which triangles are similar. So looking at this figure, it's probably not too hard to see that this triangle BMG and this triangle DAG are similar. So let me write it out to you first. So triangle BMG is similar to triangle DAG. Okay? If you want me to prove it, it's actually not too hard. I can quickly show you how to prove that these two triangles are similar. First of all, if you look at angle BMG, angle BMG, I know it is equal to angle GAD. So this angle here is the same as this angle. What's the reason of that? The reason is they are alternate angles BC parallel to AD. Because it is a parallelogram, I know already that BC and AD are parallel. So this angle has to be the same as this angle, okay? So that's what I've written here. And then I can also write the same thing for the other angle. I can also write the same thing for angle MBG, which is this angle here, is equal to angle GDA. What's the reason? The reason is also alternate angles, BC parallel to AD. So if you're doing your exercise or writing in an exam, you have to write the whole thing. But for now, I'll just put like this, okay? So it's the same reasoning as the one above, okay? So now we have two angles. We know that for this triangle and this triangle, two angles are the same. And what about the third angle? The third angle is angle BGM is also equal to angle AGD. So I'm looking at this angle here. This angle has to be the same as this angle. What's the reason? The reason is vertically opposite angles. Okay, so now we have shown that for this triangle and this triangle, all three angles for this triangle is the same as all three angles in this triangle. So we have proven that. And what's the reason? The reason is AAA, angle, angle, angle. Okay, so after we know that these two triangles are similar, then we can draw a conclusion about the area. The area of triangle BMG divided by area of triangle DAG will be the ratio of their length squared. 1/3 is the ratio of their length because for this triangle BMG, this length here is x, and for this triangle GAD, the length of AD is 3x. So the length ratio of these two similar triangles is 1 to 3, and the area will then be 1 over 3 squared. So this is 1/9. Okay, after we find this 1/9, we know that the area of this triangle DAG is 9 times this, and this is 1, right? So we know the area of this is 9. So now, if we want to know the area of this parallelogram, we at least have to know the area of this triangle here, AGB. Once we know the area of this triangle AGB, we know the area of triangle ABD. And this ABD here is actually half of the parallelogram, okay? So if we know the area of this triangle, we know the area of this triangle, and we can immediately get the answer of this question, okay? So now we have to find this. So how do we find this area? This may be a little bit complicated, because for you to find this area, you have to understand one thing. You have to understand the ratio of MG to GA. The ratio of MG to GA. MG to GA. And what's the ratio of MG to GA? Because I already proved that these two triangles are similar. So MG divided by GA will be equal to BM divided by AD. BM divided by AD. What's the reason of this? The reason is corresponding sides similar triangles, okay? Because MG is here, okay? So it's one side of this triangle. GA is here, so that's the corresponding side of the other similar triangle. So MG divided by GA must be equal to BM over BM divided by AD, okay? And MG divided by GA is BM over AD, and BM is x, and AD is 3x, So this is 1/3. So if I try to show this 1/3 on this figure here, it will be here like this. So it'll be 1/3. So 3 to 1, 1 to 3. Okay? So now if we go back to the second point that I talked about, the ratio of this black shaded triangle to this red shaded triangle is x to y. And what I have shown here is the base of this triangle ABG is 3, and the base of this triangle BMG is 1. So I know that the area of this to the area of this is also 1/3. Area of triangle BGM to the area of triangle BGA is 1/3. So I can write a 3 here. Because the area of this is 1, so this is 3. Okay? So now we have pretty much answered the question. Because we know that area of triangle BDA is 3 plus 9. Now we shouldn't forget about the unit. We have to write it out cm squared. So it is 12 cm squared. Okay? So we know the area of this triangle is 12 cm squared. And the whole thing, this whole ABCD thing is a parallelogram. So the area of ABCD will be twice the area of triangle ABD. So area of parallelogram ABCD will be 2 times area of triangle BDA. So it'll be 2 times 12 cm squared. So that's 24 cm squared. And that's your answer.